Hello everyone, myself Prashant Kalidas Kavale. I am assistant professor in mechanical engineering department, KK Wagh Institute of Engineering Education, Research, Nashik. So subject hydraulic pneumatic, and today's topic is industrial circuit design. So after completing this session, the participant will able to explain what is the considerations in designing a hydraulic circuits, analysis of regenerative hydraulic circuits and its application. So we'll concentrate on regenerative circuit. So industrial circuits design. So what is meant by industrial hydraulic circuits? A hydraulic circuit is a group of components such as pumps, actuators, control valves, conductors and fittings arranged to perform a useful work. So what are the considerations in designing a hydraulic circuit? So first, most important, safety of a person and machine in the event of power failure, because hydraulic works under very high pressure range, 200 to 700 bars. Performance of a given operation with minimum losses. So when the losses are minimum, so what is the efficiency will be maximum. So losses most of the times in terms of leakages. Okay. Then cost of the component used in the circuit. So the circuit or the system should be economical. So these are the three most important considerations in designing a hydraulic circuits. So dear all, in front of you, it's a regenerative circuit. Just observe it carefully. What is its purpose? Purpose is to speed up the extending speed of a double acting cylinder. So this is the reservoir, filter, pump, pressure relief valve, 4x3 DCV, and this is double acting cylinder. So if you observe carefully, one of the port of a DCV is screwed, and A and B port of the actuator are connected in such a way that during the extension stroke it will act as a the rod end side of the fluid will not go to the tank. It is connected to the pump flow. So what is happening? The flow will be increases and the extension speed will be increases, and retraction speed will be same as a normal double acting cylinder. So what is happening in normal double acting cylinder? Your retraction speed will be always greater than the extension speed, because change in area. Okay, so we'll try to analyze the thing. So total flow rate QT entering into that blank inside of the cylinder, is given by total flow rate is nothing but pump flow plus the flow due to the rod end side, which is not going to the tank, which is entering into the pump side. So what is the total flow? QP plus QR. So we are interested in what is the pump flow rate? QT minus QR. So what is the QT? Total. Total entering into the tank, we apply the continuity equation. Piston area. Okay. And extension velocity, blank inside. Now same liquid will be coming through this side. So what is the rod end side flow? Rod end side flow, it's this rod area is AR and piston area is AP. So what is the effective area? AP minus AR multiplied by the extension velocity, rod end side. So we just put in these two values into this equation. So we are getting QP is nothing but AR into V extension. What is mean by AR? AR is nothing but the cross-sectional area of a rod. Now, Q QP is equal to AR into V extension. V extension is QP upon AR. So please see that compared to the normal double acting cylinder, regenerative cylinder extension speed is depend upon rod cross section area. So extended speed can be greater than the retracting speed if the rod area is made smaller and smaller. So there are some practical limitations. So what is the retraction velocity? Retraction velocity is QP is equal to AP minus AR. Now we'll take the ratio of extension speed to the retraction speed. So we get AP by AR minus 1. So if you, when the piston area is equal, piston area is equal to 2 times of rod area, then extension speed becomes equal to the retraction speed. In general, the greater the ratio of piston area to the rod area, the greater is the ratio of extending speed to the retraction speed. Now what about the load carrying capacity? The load carrying capacity of a regenerative cylinder during the extension is less than the obtained from regular double acting cylinder. This is because system pressure acts on the both side of a piston during the extension. Then F load extension is equal to P multiplied by AR, rod inside area. Thus, we do not obtain more power from the regenerative cylinder during the extension because the extension PD increases at the expense of reduced load carrying capacity. This is exactly the analysis. Of a regenerative circuit. Now what is the practical application of the regenerative circuit? Practical application of the regenerative circuit is, it is used in drilling machine, but it is not in make in a right envelope or left envelope. It is used in the center position regenerative. So when it's ideal condition, that time the drill bit will go to its normal position very fast. Okay, so this is exactly the application of regenerative circuit. So in this position, pump flow goes to A. Flow from the rod inside cylinder also joins the pump flow to give the rapid spindle advance. No work is done during this period. So when there is the ideal, the spindle should go to its normal condition. Okay, so these are the references. If you like this video, then like it. Also, please subscribe my YouTube channel by pressing the bell icon. Never miss the update. Thank you.